Omar wants broccoli. Omar wants broccoli. Omar wants broccoli. We just went for another walk. We went the same direction, same distance. We must not have dilly-dallied at some points because it only took 40 minutes instead of 50. Same thing, though. We went the same way. Did exactly the same things, but I guess we walked faster or there was 10 minutes less dilly-dallying. I don't know. This was only a 40-minute walk this morning. It was a 50-minute walk. Because this morning was from 6:40 to 7:30. And just now was from 1:35 to 2:15 or something. Yeah, 1:35 to 2:15. He went another poopoo though, so that's good, right? Right? He went another poopoo. He wants broccoli. You want broccoli, don't you, honey? Broccoli. So I washed that coat, and I remember looking at it. I remember now there's stuff on it, and I don't know where it came from. Very strange. Can't tell what it is. Don't know where it came from. I don't remember brushing it in any trees. I think like it could be sap or something. It's like, it's weird. I don't know. I need to scrub it out though. I like that coat. So it's like, oh, I'm sorry, so it was 12:35 to 1:15, it's not 2:15, because it's now like 1:30 around there, and I opened up all the windows again. I closed them, obviously, when I left, and when it gets dark, obviously, I'm not going to keep them all open. Remember, this is step one of airing out the place. Per my shelter friend's recommendation. I need to finish watching that show, that movie. The woman who's new to this park, you know, hasn't been here long enough to hear the rumors, and I said as much to her. She doesn't understand what's going on. She's like, I tell her my mom's in the hospital. You gonna go visit her? No. Do you want me? I can take you to go visit her. And I said, no, that's okay. And then I said something like, I don't want to burden you. It's complicated. I'm going through a lot. My shelter friend said, you know, you should have said your mom had a breakdown. You don't have to get into details, but people have breakdowns, you know? Because this woman's thinking that my mom's local, and she can take me to the hospital. I mean, it's still so nice. I just met her a few days ago, you know? She saw me walking in the pouring rain to catch the bus. I don't have to walk over a mile to catch the bus. And she asked me if I wanted a ride. Some people, occasionally, most people don't, though. Another woman's offered me a ride too, and again, she's someone who hasn't lived here in this park very long. Believe me, the people who've been here a long time tell people, you know what I mean? My mom and me too, but my mom, you know, because remember, my mom was here when I was living in L.A., and, you know, has a reputation here. Not a good one, you know? It's not my fault. I knew, you know, when, she was giving me a ride home. I mean, it's common that someone's going to say, you know, have a good Thanksgiving, or what are you doing for the, and I said, I should have just said thank you, but, you know, if it's a new friend, it's really nice. I don't want to hide everything from her either, you know, so I said, it's not going to be good. How come? My mom's not here. Oh, where's your mom? In the hospital. Oh, are you going to go visit her? I'm like, no. And she knows I don't have a car. She's like, oh, do you want me to drive you to the hospital to visit her tomorrow? And then I said, no. And then I kind of just dropped it. I said, it's complicated, and I don't want to burden you, and that's the truth. Especially with all this, there's too much shit going on. My shelter friend agreed with me. She's like, no, you cannot burden some new person in your life, you know, who's so nice. You cannot burden her with this. It's too complicated, but you can give her the very bare, you know, the very bare essentials, the bare basics of what's going on. You can only say your mom's had a breakdown and she's in a mental hospital, not local, you know. And she said also just say it's complicated. It has to do with family and whatnot, family matters, and it's just, I don't want to burden you, and leave it at that. Now, she's really, really nice. Even if she was really nice and said, oh, I don't care where it is, I'll drive you there. I don't want to get a brand new friend, you know, involved in this. And as the Thanksgiving people and my window's open. Omar, they're outside. They're outside. See, I can let him run through the house now. He's peed and poo-pooed. He's fine. He's not going to pee and poop for a while now. All the nice, happy people having their nice, happy Thanksgiving. And here I am, all alone with Omar, watching DVDs, chowing down on junk food. And then, you know, in the clean, too. I'm airing out the windows, airing out the place. Have every window in the house open, except for the one in the laundry room. That's too hard to open. I'm liable to fall. I must fail. I don't like that window either, because people could see in when you're doing laundry. Shade on it or anything. Oh my goodness. I need to return that gate. All the libraries are closed on Friday. Probably even in other states' libraries closed on Friday. But all the ones around here. I mean, I'm not even just talking the one in my mom's city. They're all closed on Friday. So I can't return that gate until I find out the procedure for returning the gate. You know what I mean? They might have to send you a return shipping thing, or you have to pay for shipping, but some places, even if you have to pay for shipping, they subtract that from the amount of refund they give you, whatnot, but they still want you to put something on the box so they know it's coming back, you know, so I can't do that on my own until I talk to them. So I can't do that Friday. said, no matter how much junk food I eat between last night and today, I'm still not going to get the amount of fat and calories and whatnot as people celebrating traditional Thanksgiving, you know, with the traditional Thanksgiving dinners. You stuff yourself to oblivion, and oh, how I remember so well those days. Right, Omas? You want broccoli? Broccoli? He wants broccoli. Broccoli? Yeah. Mama doesn't eat meat like Grandma does, but I give you apple and cheese and broccoli. Just a little bit of cheese. Just a little bit of cheese. And when I have my throw string cheese, organic, or I have, you know, that organic block of cheddar, you know, I don't give him cheese all the time. Just a little bit of cheese. Little treat. Little treat to broccoli. You want broccoli? Mama's going to give you a whole bunch of broccoli to celebrate, because even though I don't care about Thanksgiving, and, you know, I'm going to give him some extra broccoli. And remember, I shared my organic summer squash and zucchini with him. Broccoli? Mrs. Omar getting excited. You're not fat. Broccoli? Come here. Broccoli? 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 He knows broccoli. Broccoli? See, he knows. Broccoli? Broccoli? Broccoli. You want broccoli? Oh, by the way, Omar hates laughter. Laughter on the TV bothers him. He gets mad. Want some broccoli? Let me take your leash off. You don't need that on. You just got back from my walk. I'm going to take your leash off. Come here. It's wrapped around your leg. Come here. Come here. Come here. I got to get this. Come here. Up. Come on. Come on. I'm going to give you broccoli. I'm going to take your leash off, though. Come on. Up. Come on. Up. Come on. Broccoli? I'm going to ignore you and give you broccoli unless you come back up here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let me take the leash off. Come here. You don't need it on. Broccoli? Broccoli. Chopping broccoli. Chopping broccoli. All right, I'm gonna go give him broccoli, guys. Bye.